Alrighty, so we're going to continue moving forward. We talked about our last lesson was social reforms. We kind of hit on reform meaning changing for a better cause or a better situation. We hit on the reforms in religion and the Second Great Awakening and these revivals where everybody's getting, you know, back in church and how the memberships and churches are going through the roof. We talked about how you should strive to be the perfect Christian, and by doing this, you have to take certain steps. And one was, you know, the banning of alcohol. How alcohol makes you turn into this person that ends up being broke, or you know, a home wrecker, or you know, committing crimes and so on. Then we moved on to the reforming of education, where we talked about the great movement from Horace Mann, where he's pushing this and he's making people realize that education is such an important thing that we need to try to reach as many people as we possibly can and allow them to get this education. We pulled up a document, a journal of his, where he was talking about, you know, how important just, you know, things that we might overlook, but how important the lighting in a room is, or ventilation, or, you know, the way the classroom desks are set up and so on, which it's things like we said, we're still doing that today. Then we kind of went to a higher education where now it was being allowed for more people to go, mostly men, but, you know, we still saw some exceptions where there were some colleges opening for women, and also that there was colleges that African Americans were allowed to go to. So that was some steps moving forward. We started paying attention to people with special needs and how we could improve, you know, their education, how they still could learn. It just needed, you know, special treatment. Whereas we had Thomas Gaudet, we had Samuel Gridley. They're doing the books, they're doing the Braille to try to help out in sign language and things like that. All right, so that brings us to where we're at today. We're talking about abolitionists. And our first slide is the definition: a reformer who worked to abolish or end slavery. So we're still pre-Civil War. We're still, you know, having the clashes, and there's a big tension between the North and the South. And you have a lot of people that are working to free slaves. They're saying, you know, it's an outcry, how wrong it is, and it needs to be over with. Okay, so let's see. By the early 1800s, slavery was no longer allowed in the North, but it continued in the South. So we've kind of hit on what the North did for an economy boost and what the South does to boost its economy. Obviously, the South is farming, and that's since the reason why the South is holding on to slavery. The North, the soil is rocky. It's not you know, good for growing crops. So the South is ideal, and they're wanting slavery. They think the only way they can continue this and to have that economy is to have slavery. All right. So the first significant anti-slavery movement, we have the American Colonization Society, and basically what they're going to do, they're going to try to buy slaves. They're going to take money from private donors, from Congress, from state legislators, and they're getting these donations. And the whole end game is they're going to use the money, they're going to buy slaves, and then they're going to resettle them and give them their freedom, okay? So we'll see like Liberia, it's going to be a country that's eventually going to be a country. And what it is, they're shipping these former slaves that were purchased, and now they're going to be free. They're going to ship them back to this area in between in the Caribbean and also in Africa. Up until about the Civil War, it's, you know, experts say between 12,000 and 20,000 slaves were bought and sent there. But it doesn't put a dent in what the South is still doing. The South's slave population is still just rising through the roof. So these colonizations that are doing great things, they're not able to catch up with the increased population of slaves in the South. So we have William Lloyd Garrison. Okay, he calls for the immediate and complete emancipation of enslaved people. So basically he says, you know, you have different ideals of these abolitionists. Some say, let's gradually start letting a number, like a percentage of slaves be released. And then you have some like William Lloyd Garrison that says, no, you know, we need to let everyone on free right now. So if we're in the classroom situation, I would pause here and I would say, all right, let's think for about a minute. I want you to come up with me a good answer and tell me if you think this is a good idea, if you think this is a bad idea, what kind of problems we could face. And if you had the power in the situation, would you do a gradual release or would you do a complete all at once release? And I would let you sit there for about a minute. And then I would call on some or take some, you know, people to raise their hands. And I would hope to get some answers like, well, I could see a problem if you released all of them at once that you don't know how these former slaves would react. Or that's a lot of people needing jobs. Or that's a lot of people who are going to need places to stay. And then you could say, well, that there wouldn't be any slaves anymore, so it wouldn't be any more injustice. So you should let them all go at once. Or you could argue that if you do it slowly, that allows your population to get adjusted. That allows these slaves to find jobs, and then you release some more gradually, and that allows them to find jobs and housing and things like that. So there's arguments on both sides of that. Garrison is just one that says, no, we need to release them all now, and let's get it done. So he actually starts the Liberator, which is a newspaper in Boston. Then we move on and we talk about the Grimsky sisters. So the Grimsky sisters, they're born in South Carolina, so they're Southerners. They're born to a wealthy farming family. They've got money. They've got a plantation. They're slaveholding, okay? So the story with the Grimsky sisters is they kind of convince their mother to go ahead and give them their inheritance early. Now, they don't want money. They don't want land. They tell her they want X number of slaves, and that would be, you know, their inheritance. We've already covered that that slaves are very, very expensive, okay? So they're saying, you know, we don't want the money or land. We just want X number of slaves. That'll be our inheritance. So the mother, she says, okay, that's fair enough. She gives them some slaves, and immediately the Grimsky sisters move up north, and they free the slaves, okay? So it says they were born, like we said, South Carolina. Asked for the inheritance of slaves, moved north. And then they write the American Society. So basically this is a journal of them. It describes events that they went through on the farm, what they saw, how these slaves were treated and how they were punished. And we've kind of covered this in class, you know, the brutality of the punishments because, you know, you wanted the slaves to fear you. That way they wouldn't try to fight back or they wouldn't try to escape. So they write about this, and it opens, and it reaches a lot of people, and it opens a lot of eyes of, you know, a firsthand accountance of what really goes on these plantations. All right, Frederick Douglass. So runaway slave becomes a very, very important, influential speaker. It says, I've actually got a quote that I'm going to read about Frederick Douglass. It says, "What to the American slave is your 4th of July? I answer, a day that reveals to him more than all other days in the year the gross injustice and cruelty to which he is a constant victim. To him, your celebration is a sham, your national greatness swelling vanity. Your sounds of rejoicing are empty and heartless, your shouts of liberty and equality hollow mockery." So we think about that. Again, this would be another time in class where I would read this, or I'd have you read this, and I'd let you ponder on it for a moment, come up with me a good answer on your explanation, because these are words that, you know, the way this is written, we don't talk like that today, but you should get some kind of understanding. So basically, Frederick Douglass is saying, you know, you're celebrating how great of a country this is because we won our independence, you know, July the 4th. He's saying, you know, you celebrate how awesome this country is and how liberty and equality and how great that is. But then he says, that's a hollow mockery. Like, that's a joke. There's no equality. Can you honestly sit there and say that this country is built on liberty and equality for all when we have bondage, we have slavery, we're still fighting this fight like I said, this is pre-Civil War, so you know there's still these slaves. And he's saying, no, this is not a great country. This is not a honest and equality-based country. This is still a sham. It's a joke. But Frederick Douglass gets fame. He travels. He actually goes abroad to Europe because he's a runaway slave, so technically he could be arrested. Finally, some people come up with some money, and they pay his former slaveholder for his freedom so he can come back to the States, and he's a free man. All right, Sojourner Truth, born into slavery, named Isabella Bowman, escapes to the North and changes her name and worked for the abolition of slavery and women's rights. She actually, during the war, when the Civil War starts, she actually is a recruiter for the North. So she goes around and she convinces these African-Americans to join the fight, to help fight the North. And they kind of form their own regiments, and she actually collects supplies and things they need to help them out. So a very important part of this history. All right, so the Underground Railroad. I'm sure we have heard of this. This is not an actual train with tracks and all this. So like the notes say, the Underground Railroad is a secret organization to help African Americans escape from slavery. Runaways travel by night following the North Star. They're in the South. They find the North Star. That points them in the North direction. Most famous conductor, Harriet Tubman, which we'll get to Harriet Tubman in just a moment. So basically, this is trails. These are routes that these slaves, when they're escaping, they're following the North Star to try to get past the Mason-Dixon line, which separates the South from the North. And that they come up with these codes, these names, these words for safe houses. They would put things out to say, hey, this is a safe house. These people will help you. If you can get there, you can stay. They'll give you food, supplies, and so on. So what I've actually got for you, we're going to play a little bit of a song to give you a little idea of what the Underground Railroad meant. Let's see if we can get it to work. And it might not work. All right, let's see. So basically, the song is called Follow the Drinking Gore. And what that is if you've ever looked out and you've heard of the Big Dipper or the Little Dipper. So the Drinking Gore, the Big Dipper, it looks like a gore to something you get water and scoop water out to drink. So the Big Dipper, and it's saying follow the Drinking Gore because that's representing the Big Dipper, which points points to the North Star. So follow the drinking gore. That's leading you to the North Star. And this goes on, and it has, you know, different verses in here that tell you to look for this or feel for this or things like that to help you get there safely. It says they would feel the moss on the because it grew on the side of the trees they need to be going. And, you know, like I said, certain houses would have things out there that represented a safe house. And like we said, Harriet Tubman led hundreds of slaves to freedom, risking her life going back and forth. So she was an escapee, made it to the North. And instead of just being satisfied with being, you know, free, she came back into the South and led these runaway slaves to freedom, coming back and forth, making several trips, risking her life and her own freedom to try to, you know, help out the rest of these slaves. So she's, you know, very, very important person in history. All right, so we have opposition to this. You have opposition from the North and also, of course, opposition from the South of freeing slaves. So it says some reason that the Northerners feared, they feel that a civil war between the North and South would happen if you did free these slaves, which ultimately happens anyway, but that was their big thing. Hey, if we keep pushing this issue, it's going to be a civil war, and we don't want our own country fighting our own people. Another one, the freed slaves would never fit into American society. So what they're saying there is basically they're not going to work out in society. They're not, you know, they lived a life of slavery for so long. That's how they're adjusted to. They're not going to be able to fit in and make it. And other ones, like we said, that, you know, you free all these slaves, they're going to need jobs. So the Northerners are scared that they might take their jobs. And then other opposition, Southerners claimed slavery was essential. Like we said, if you take this away, they feared that their economy would crash, they would go broke, and they had to have these slaves to survive. All right, and in class, I would pull this up, and I would ask you this question and give you a response. So was the abolitionist movement inedible? So basically, did it have to happen? Did it, you know, what was the reasoning by it? Did, you know, so why did it happen? What affected it? How? And that's what I would hope to get some answers. Like, yes, I mean, without, you know, these abolitionists, would we really, you know, would slavery have ended then, or would it be later, or so on? So that would be some things that I would expect you to answer. All right. So I hope you got something out of this. Stay safe. I hope to see y'all soon. Thank you.